All eyes on Luka Modric. It's his debut today, and we have it live for you next on EA TV. And a warm welcome on what is an ideal night for football, you've got to say. I'm Derek Ray in the commentary position, and alongside me is the former Arsenal and West Ham midfield player Stuart Robson. And it is a day of renewal, the first game of the Premier League season. Always something to look forward to. It's Brentford, and they take on Arsenal.
Well, the atmosphere is incredible inside the stadium.
Well, it's a really poor challenge. Now, what's the referee going to do about it? We're going to see the first yellow card of the game. The referee not standing on ceremony.
Well, he's under pressure now. It's a long time to be on a booking.
It's a weighted pass. There it is! The opening goal of this match. And what a start they've made.
Well, it's a goal you'd expect him to score, but he kept his cool and he put it away nicely. He'll be happy with that.
And they're playing again, and Arsenal are leading. Now, potential danger. He's in behind the defence here. And it's a penalty. The referee points to the spot, and it's going from bad to worse. Well, no card handed out. He gets away with a rebuke.
Well, a lot of referees would have booked him there, but I'm with him on this one. No yellow card for me.
A chance to extend the lead. And he slots it home with confidence.
Well, let's take another look. And it's a very good goal. And they deserve it, you have to say. They've been excellent.
So 2-0 now. Well, it's always intriguing when a new manager arrives in the technical area. Stuart, will the Champions League be in their future?
Well, they've brought him in to get the best out of some very talented players. But unless he does get that Champions League football, as you said, he'll be under a bit of pressure.
Martin Ødegaard. Now with Pepe. Oh, he's gone for goal! So following the deflection, a corner kick coming up here. Playing it in. And no-nonsense defensive clearance. This appears to be in control. Luka Modric. And he's clear his lines. Da Silva. Ivan Toney. Franco Onyeka, and space for the cross. And danger still. Well, the counter chance looks very real. Delightful pass. He might yet finish. Well, tremendous block. Oh, he's given it away.
Well, as you can see, Arsenal have had most of the ball and as a result have dominated the game. Some of their passing movements have been a joy to watch and I don't think anything's going to change that.
He's protecting it effectively. That's how to blunt the edge of the opposing attack. Arsenal's free kick here. Thomas Partey. Modric, Lacazette. Well, can they open up the defence here? Lacazette. And Lacazette this time. And a little too close to the keeper in the end. Getting forward. Mbeumo. Excellent assessment of the situation at the back. Will he find the net? And a goal to increase their advantage to three. Can they be stopped? So the game continues, and Arsenal cantering to victory now. Mbeumo.
Can he find the net?
Really good diving stop to make sure the threat came to nothing. Can someone get on the end of this? Well, being closely marked, but the header nothing to write home about. And with that, the first half draws to a close. Into the second half after a dominant first half performance by Arsenal. Really nice ball. And he's in. Able to get his body in the way. Oh, he's given us away inexplicably. And this time it's in. Fabulous goal, and just look at the celebrations. So they get the ball moving again. 3-1 the scoreline here. What's going to happen next? Playing with purpose and control. Kieran Tierney. Partey. And a crisp effort just over the top. Well, they've decided to make a change. And the story now confirmed, Spurs have got their man, Stuart.
Well, the figure that's being quoted is around the £35 million mark, which in my view looks to be just about right. Let's hope he fits in quickly and justifies that price tag.
Well, danger here as he runs at them. Sends it back. And in! Oh, yes! Exactly what they were hoping to produce. They've delivered the goal. Goals in plentiful supply. 4-1 currently. Roslev with it. It's there for him. It's gone in! And well, he might celebrate on the back of that. So the current scoreline, 4-2. And the emphasis is on creativity. Could pull one back here. He scored once already and close to making it a double.
Well, every time he gets on the ball, he looks a real danger today.
And over it comes. And still dangerous. He read the cross, but now must clatter it clear. Crucial intervention just then amid impending danger. Well, we have 20 minutes left in this game. Just a reminder, we have more absorbing action from the Premier League coming your way here on EA TV. It's Brentford facing Crystal Palace. Luka Modric at the ready. And a struggle to get it away properly. Well, that's the end of that for now. Well, in the dying embers of the game, but Arsenal still full of life, a most enjoyable performance.
Well, they've controlled most of the game, haven't they? Their one and two touch passing has been sharp, the movement's been bright, and they've scored some good goals. They just need to keep their concentration through to the final whistle.
And far from the ideal cross, keeper's ball all the way. Partey. It's with Ødegaard. 10 minutes to go then. Mazraoui. The cross is on. Well, it's unable to make anything of the cross. This might be ideal for the counter. Now what can they do from here? Well, a badly timed run, just a fraction offside. And time for the change now.
Number 8, Matthias Jensen. And number 19, Brian
effective challenge. Arsenal's free kick here. Mazraoui. It's with Odegaard. Thomas Partey. This is looking threatening. But ultimately up a cul-de-sac. So 2 minutes of stoppage time here. Ivan Toney. And there to intervene. So there goes the final whistle. It ends at a victory.
Just a couple of questions for you. Thanks, that's all.